Thank you. Thank you. Hare 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 we should begin that we, you should come here or we can follow. আর এই চলে আসে এখানে বসতে পারে কেন
সাজিয়েছে কি সুন্দর করে
অজ্ঞাত বিরান্ধস্য জ্ঞানং জনশলাকয়া চক্ষুরুন্মীলিতং যেন তস্মৈ শ্রীগুরবে वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महावदन्नाय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदाय ते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्य नाम्ने गौरद्विषे नमः गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकाय विरुक्तदाय कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तदभक्ताय नमो यं प्रव्रजन्तमनुपेतमपेतकृत्यं द्वैपायनो विरहभातर्याजुहव पुत्रेति तन्मयतया सर्वोऽभिनेदु तं सर्वभूतहृदयं मुनिमानतोऽस्मि तवैवास्मि न जीवामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञाय राधे संनय मां चरणानि First of all, my millions and millions of dandat pranam in the lotus feet of my spiritual master, Nitya Lila Pravishtam Vishnupad Srimad Bhakti Pragyan Kesava Goswami. And same in the lotus feet of my Shiksha Guru, Nitya Lila Pravishtam Vishnupad Ashwata Srimad भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी महाराज आई एम वेरी हैप्पी दैट सो मेनी डिवोटीज आर हियर इन टू इयर्स आई हैव नॉट कम हियर थ्री इयर्स बिकॉज Australia's government gets something trouble. So, for old person, they don't give this visa. That you will be sick, and then my government has to expense. But now I don't know when I will come. But my representatives, Padmanabh Maharaj, Damodar Maharaj, Shyam Rani, Chidandi Maharaj, Van Maharaj, Tirth Maharaj, all will come. And if I will be okay, I also may come. I am very indebted to my Shiksha Guru, Nitya Lila Pravishtam Vishnupad Ashwata Srimad Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj. He took sannyas in Keshavji Gaudiya Math with our holy master Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Bhakti Pragyan Keshav Goswami Maharaj. And very soon, he began to preach, and in couple of years, everywhere, in the midst of mountains, high mountains, in the midst of oceans, jungle, everywhere, town, villages, cities, he preached the mission of a Gurudev and Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Not only this, he wrote authentic books, translation of Srimad Bhagavat Chaitanya Charitamrita, and so many books he wrote. I think you are all coming by his grace anyhow. Especially in his last day, when we are departing from this world, he called me and began to weep, and taking my hands in his hand, he told, "Lord, I have brought so many devotees from whole world," and in Bengali he told that, "I have brought so many monkeys from whole world, but I could not train them. So I request you to help them. I promise that I will help you." And secondly he told, "Oh, with your own hand you should give my samadhi. And in your supervision, my Viraha Mahotsav will be done. I did all these things with all my own hand." Kamal Krishna and his so many disciples, prominent, were there, but he never told them for giving his samadhi. Also, there are so many god brothers like Van Maharaj and all other in Vrindavan, but he not told. He requested me to. There should be something there. He has written me once, "Oh, our relation is transcendental, as my relation is transcendental with Srila Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati was your transcendental relation with me is the same." So he used to, in so many cases, on me, and he wanted that he should come and preach with me. At that time, any reason, I could not come. But to fulfill that promise that I will help, so I am coming to whole world, and I am seeing his glory everywhere, in whole world, even where he could not go, and I am going, even there also, his glory I am seeing. A common person cannot do preaching like this. So, anything, any power from Supreme Lord was in him, and that is why he preached over the whole world. Today, I am giving my millions and millions of dandas pranam in his lotus feet. Then, I am beginning my classes. I was thinking that from so many 15 years, perhaps, I am coming here. 11 years I am coming here and giving classes. So what subject I should deal, I was thinking. I asked, "What name?" Chandramukhi. I will ask, discuss with Padmanabha Maharaj and other thought subject. And I told that, "What do you want?" Then he told, "Yeah, I have heard that you have discussed about 10th canto. And it was very, very attractive.
11.
So, 11 canto. So, If you can deal with that, oh, then I told, oh, very good subject. So we will speak on that subject, 11th canto. Very, very interesting and very, very helpful. But I want to tell you that once about 88,000 of rishis of India came to Namisharanya. Kali Yuga is coming. What to do? Sut Goswami was also there. They were just discussing. Now Kali Yuga is coming. And everything will be upset. Especially, the age will be so much less ways. Think that suppose our age is 100, 50 years in sleeping, in bed, all sleep, and if uncontrolled senses and sense gratification is there so much, then more than 50. At least 50, we go in then. And from boyhood to up to 20 years, goes in vain in being expert in business, in service, qualified to earn money and these things. And from 8200, too old, they cannot walk even. So many ropes. We cannot do anything. And 10 years, you know, now so much wealth coming, sense gratification coming. A house should be so good that all kinds of facilities should be there. Oh, on switch, dining room comes. Switch, then toilet comes. Oh, switch, then meeting hall. And again switch, bathroom, and so many things. Cars. So, for collecting all these things for sense gratification, so much time goes. Marriage is also essential, and then children to make qualified everything. So when you will do bhajan? Not any single time. Whole time uselessly, like donkeys, you use to spoil. What you are doing to collect money? Money cannot give you happiness. You should know. Never. Especially when you will die, you cannot take a single quarter trillion last point.
Sense.
You cannot take. Then if you cannot take, and if your relatives, your son, daughter, wife, all qualified persons, they cannot go with you, then why you are doing so level like donkeys? Why you are not thinking about Krishna? You should know that you are part and parcel of Krishna. And in your transcendental form, there is mood to serve Krishna. But why we came here? You know, when we forget Krishna, at once illusory Maya, Krishna Maya came and took us and gave two bodies gross body, material body and
subtle body.
Subtle body. And then and this body and they are all mine. Wealth is mine. Dogs are mine. Especially nowadays in Australia and Western countries I see each person must have 2, 3, 4 dogs. They will make bath of that with soap. They will throw out his Latin and everything, but not they will start to their father, mother. Father is dying in old houses, but they will not care. This is Kali Yuga. So they are asking, Sukh Goswami, oh, you are disciple of Maha Maha Bhagavat, Sri Sukadeva Goswami, who has learned Srimad Bhagavat, the essence of all the Indian Vedic literature. The essence of all the Vedic literature is Brahma Sutra and Srimad Bhagavat, the essence of that. So if anyone has learned Srimad Bhagavat, he has heard Srimad Bhagavat from his bona fide guru. So you are like so. So we ask you that in this situation, in this coming Kali Yuga, everything is upset. Ladies, half naked, full naked, only something here. On the sea beach you can see, they are distributing their beauty. What wonderful. Nothing. Anything to parda, parda ke liye. To cover anything. No need that at all. And bogus. Nowadays the roaming, walking on this, the people like shame. They have no shame in anything. Ladies, generally, they will change their husbands 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and they want to write their name in Greenwich.
Greenwich World Book. Guinness Book of Records.
And a son cannot tell that, oh, who is my father? This time we I'm seeing just now coming. So what should we do? You are very intelligent, you know the essence of Ved, Upanishad, Puran, Bhagavat, everything. So you should tell Jayatma Samprasidati. How soul will be happy? He never asked that how we will, this body will be happy. This body is mortal. We are not this body, you should know all. You should forget that I am this body. And in this part and parcel of Krishna, and Krishna is also here. Both are here. Krishna is, oh, he knows Jiva and he is looking after Jiva. What he is doing, where they are going. And according to that, he is getting some fruits. Narak, Swarga and so many things. And another, oh, Krishna is there but cannot know that, oh, where is my friend? So, how we can be happy? Guru Krishna Prasade Pai Bhakti Latapi. Krishna Kripa is very high, but it is controlled by Guru Kripa. Krishna Kripa is not Swatantra,
independent.
It depends on Guru Kripa. Guru is Pratinidhi,
representative
of Krishna. So, if I have no bona fide Guru, qualified Guru, how he can show you that power? Bhakti is very hidden, very, very hidden. So, hearing his question, he became very happy. And he did pranam to his Gurudev Sukhdev Goswami and began to tell. Sabai punsan paro dharmo jato bhakti ratho khaje ahet tu kya abdavahita ja bhakti purushottam. Srila Rupa Goswami, inspired by Srila Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself, he wrote a poem like this. What has been told in Srimad Bhagavatam, what has been told in other books, combination of all comprehensive, anyabhilasita sunyam, jnan karma dhyanabhidam, ankullena krishna anusilanam bhakti. What is the meaning? We have discussed this matter so many times, but I am reminding you the definition of bhakti and try to follow you all this bhakti.
We have just heard in the Srimad Bhagavatam. One definition of bhakti has been given. Sarvai punsam paro dharma yatir bhakti adhocare vaitiki apatiyata yapam sampasivitam. Therefore, Sri Sukhdeva Goswami has defined bhakti as sarvai punsam, the highest occupation of the soul, yatir bhakti adhocare, is devotional service to the Supreme Lord, who is known as adhocare. Adhocare means the Supreme Lord who is beyond the range of the material senses. When that devotional service is performed uninterruptedly and without any material motivation, then it will completely satisfy the Supreme Self, Sri Krishna. And when the Supreme Lord is satisfied, automatically the individual soul will feel ecstasy. So there have been so many definitions given of devotional service. But bhakti parvesh iti ishwar, absorption in the Supreme is called bhakti. So many are there. But all will find some shortage. But Sri Rupa Goswami has taken everything from all other definitions and added something which was not previously given in one verse from the same Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. Anyabhilasita sunyam jnana karma dhyanabhidam anukulena krishna anusilanam bhakti uttama. Therefore, Sri Rupa Goswami said, what is bhakti uttama or uttam bhakti, the topmost form of devotion? So in this verse, there is both the tathagata lakshan, the external characteristics of bhakti, and the swarupa lakshan, or the intrinsic, internal, or main characteristics of devotion. The Buddha says first we should discuss the intrinsic forms of devotion. That is anukulena krishna, anukulena bhakti, anukulena
krishna-anusulyanam bhakti
uttama. Then Rupa Goswami has said, uttam bhakti is that type of devotion which is not covered by jnana, through speculative knowledge or karma, fruitive activity. It is completely bereft of any other desires.
First, explain ankullena, then go second.
Then, it is performed, it is cultivated for the satisfaction of Sri Krishna, that is called Uttambhakti. So first, what is the superproduction, or the intrinsic characteristics? Anukulena Krishnanu Silanam Bhakti Uttama. First, anukulena. It should be performed in a manner which is favorable for Krishna. And there should be some anusilanam. Silanam means a cultivation. Some people say, anukulena means practical bhavabhati, or an absence of enmity towards Krishna. But this is not enough, because even a tree, for example, has no enmity towards Krishna, but it doesn't mean it's doing anything for him. Therefore, only an absence of this favorable mood is not itself sadhu-bhakti. There must be some silam, means some cultivation. Here the Rupa Goswami has also described anu silamam. That means that cultivation is qualified by the adjective anu. Anu means continuous. Anu also means anugatya moy, under the guidance of Sri Gurudev and the Vaishnavas. So here, that cultivation is of two types. That is anukul chesta and pratikul chesta. That means cultivation means there should be some cultivation of activities which are favorable for Krishna, and it also means not performing activities which are unfavorable for devotion. Therefore, giving up things which are unfavorable for devotion. For example, performing the limbs of bhakti, that is anukul chesta, and so that means body, mind,
chesta of mind, and beyond mind, bhav.
Chesta rupa, bhav rupa.
Bhav rupa. This is chesta rupa means? What is meaning of chesta rupa?
Chesta means the endeavors of body, mind and words.
Yes.
And
whatever you do to please Krishna
should be done by body, mind and words. And bhav chesta means? Like Sanjay Bhav's emotions performed that are favorable for Krishna.
And bhav rupa?
Emotions like sunshine
bars, not for me.
Sunshine bars, emotions which are favorable for Krishna's service, like the eight different types of ecstatic emotions, the 32, 33, the Yavachari bars, sensual emotions which rise from the ocean of Saibar and return. The cultivation of these type of emotions is also one type of endeavor called Bhav Rupa. And sensual beings endeavors of body, mind, and words. Therefore, it is called anukulena. Here, some people give a simplification of this definition by saying it gives happiness to Krishna. But in this, there is two considerations given by Sri Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur in his book, Sri Bhakti Vasudeva Sindhu Bindu. He said there should not be an overextension of the definition, and neither there should be an underextension of the definition. An example of an overextension of the definition of anukulena, for example, when Krishna entered into the wrestling arena of Kamsamaraj. That time, many, many audiences were there, nine different types of people, saw Krishna with 12 different emotions. That time, the huge wrestlers, Charanamurti, they challenged Krishna, "Oh Krishna, you are subject to the king, and for his enjoyment, you should wrestle with us." Krishna said, "How can I wrestle with you? You guys are like Hulk Hogan, huge monsters. I am just a small boy. I cannot wrestle with you." Charanamurti said, "We know that you are not ordinary boy. Otherwise, how you kill big rakshasas and demons and yogis like Putana, Adaso, and Matasso? Come on." They grabbed Krishna, Charan grabbed Krishna, and Musko grabbed Balaram. And a big fight was there. Head to head, elbow to elbow, knee to knee. They were dragging Krishna here, pulling him here. They were punching each other. That time Krishna felt great ecstasy. Because Krishna is also one, he's a killer, he tastes all type of rasa or moods. One of those moods is vira, or the mood of a hero. Devakrishna also likes to qualify sometimes. There are terrible people pounding on Krishna. Krishna felt great happiness. But we cannot say this is devotion. Why? Because their intention was not to give happiness to Krishna. Their intention was to kill Krishna. It was simply that they gave happiness to Krishna. This is not an example of devotion. This is an overextension of the definition. And an underextension of the definition is sometimes a devotee may perform some activity for Krishna and Krishna is inspired by that. For example, Madhya Yashoda, Krishna is eating dirt, and Madhya Yashoda punishes him, pulls him in his ear and threatens to beat him. That's why Krishna is weeping. Is this bhakti to make Krishna cry? Krishna says this is topmost type of bhakti. Because Madhya Yashoda is beating Krishna, why? Krishna will eat this dirt inside of many seeds. Those seeds will come out of your stomach and you'll be finished. What help are you doing? And Krishna becomes a bread, O Mother, I won't eat earth again. Then even though that in Deva Anukulena, Krishna Anushilena, even though that endeavor is performed for Krishna, it's not giving happiness to Krishna, Krishna is weeping, it's called devotion because it's done for Krishna's benefit. One point here, devotion must be only for Krishna. It cannot be for Durga or Kali or Ganesh or Devadevi or anyone else or any man or woman in this world for the sake of dog or cat. Devotion can only be performed towards the Supreme Lord. And of all the incarnations of the Supreme Lord, who is the other Tali, the source of all incarnations? That is Krishna. Look, all this and so much more which I have not spoken what is in the books. That is the Sarupalakshan or the main definition, the intrinsic definition of devotion. The Srila Prabhupada is so much of a genius, he has also clarified it more by giving the Tathastra action. Anyadi vasita sunyam. That devotion should be devoid of any other desires. For example, some people are chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. I want to go to heavenly planets. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. I don't want to go to hell. I want a wife. I want this. I want good health. They are performing devotion, but it's full of desires. Desires except for the satisfaction of Krishna. Therefore, Uttam Bhakti of Pura devotion is devoid of any other desires. Therefore, a question might arise, Anyabhilas Sita, it is said Anyabhilas Sita. Why is not just said Anyabhilas? Because sometimes, even a high class devotee, there may be some extraordinary circumstance where they may call on Krishna to save them. For example, Sitropati Devi, the wife of the Pandavas. That time when Duryodhana ordered her to be stripped naked. That time she prays, Devo Vindarako Savanam Apto Jivataha. Oh Krishna, save my shame. So some may say, this is not devotion because she is saying Krishna save me, this is for her. But Sri Rupa Goswami is so broad-minded, he said, no, because this is some emergency. For example, we're going home after the program, we're going to get in the car crash, we're about to go to the front and scream, Hare Krishna, Krishna saves me. That will not be a loss of devotion because it's some extraordinary, life-threatening circumstance. Anukulena, Anyabhilasita, therefore there should be no touch of other desires. For example, so many people their devotion is mixed with what I can't say today, my astrology is not so favorable, or my lady master told me it's not good, or therefore, all these things should be abandoned. Anyabhilasita,
Anyabhilasita, worship demigods to fulfill their desires. Also, Anyabhilasita. Astrology, to read astrology and to tell others, this is against bhakti.
And this also, jnana, karma, anaditam. Devotion should not be covered by jnana and karma. Jnana means knowledge. The Rupa Goswami says, without knowledge, no one can live. For example, how do you enter this program? You have to know where the showground is. You have to know how to book a ticket on the internet. Therefore, that knowledge, without knowledge, you wouldn't even be here. Therefore, knowledge which is used favorably towards Krishna, that can be accepted. The jnana should not completely cover devotion. Especially there are three types of jnana. Tatpadat jnana, prampadat jnana, and Jnana. These first two types of knowledge, the knowledge of the Supreme Lord and knowledge of my own position, that can be accepted for devotion. Therefore, that knowledge which is favorable for devotion, that knowledge which is favorable for devotion, that we can accept. The knowledge where bhakti is destroyed, I will become one with Bhagavan, that knowledge is completely rejectable. Because if you become one with Bhagavan, you cannot serve him at all. Therefore, that type of jnana is completely rejectable. Therefore, jnana should not cover devotion. Also, karma.
Even tattva-jnana. If tattva-jnana is there, Krishna is Supreme Lord. He is creator of whole world. If this knowledge is true, but if this knowledge will be, then we cannot think that Krishna is my son or my most beloved or friend. So this knowledge also should be denied. Forget that Krishna is Supreme Lord. Swamiji came to tell you that Krishna is Supreme Lord. But I have come, he has said that, now you should tell them to forget Krishna is Supreme Lord. He is your friend, he is your most beloved, he is your son, like this.
For example, if Maria Sara goes to pull Krishna in and Krishna says, don't pull my ear, I'm Bhagavan. Then Maria Sara will give him another one. Hey, only one Bhagavan here, that Bhagavan Vishnu. Don't do any offense to him. Then Vishnu will have two or three times. Therefore, that knowledge that Krishna is Bhagavan, in the end, even that must be given up. And finally, bhakti should not be covered by karma. Means, some people say, don't do any karma. But that's impossible. How many of you got money to come to this festival? Festival please. That means in order to get money, we have to have money to go to this festival. Some of us don't work there for a while now. Don't mention the others. That means karma also can be used in a way which is favorable for devotion. Eating is also karma. Walking here and there is karma. Breathing is even a karma. Therefore, activity cannot be stopped, but activity should be used in a way which is favorable for Krishna. But karma should not cover bhakti. Kavali bhakti means, I'm so much busy, I cannot even chant my Harinam. Some people say, I have no time for chanting, we have time for reading. Therefore, some people, they're so much absorbed in making money and materialistic life, they have no time for devotion. That is an example of bhakti being covered by karma. Therefore, Uttam Bhakti or Pure Bhakti is that devotion which is cultivated by the body, mind, and words, and by emotions which are performed exclusively for the benefit of Sri Krishna. That the pure emotion should be devoid of any other desires. It should not be covered by karma or jnana or pramana.
Vasudeva Bhagavati Bhakti Yoga Prayojita Janat Asu Vairagyam Jnanam Yat Ahai Sukham. If anyone doing this Uttama Bhakti, then very soon, Vairagya will come, detachment from whole world. Surely, if you are hearing Harikatha, this Bhagavatam, Srimad Bhagavatam, told by Sukadeva Goswami and heard by Parikshit Maharaj. If anyone hears and do Uttama Bhakti, if it is beginning, no hope. First, Vairagya will come, detachment from whole world. If not coming, you should see that there is loop and hope. You are here doing bhakti, or still to have no detachment from wealth, reputation, worldly things, then it means that you are not here. You are not doing that bhakti. And secondly, tattva jnana will come. All kinds of knowledge. By doing this. Samadhan, Kirtanam, Vishnu Smaranam and Krishna Tattva, Jiva Tattva, Maya Tattva, Bhakti Tattva, Prem Tattva, Radha Tattva, Krishna Tattva, all tats you will realize. And also, Dharma Sunishita Kunsan, Bishop saying Kathasuja, Not Padya Jadigatim, Sara Evahi Kevalam. If you are doing Uttama Bhakti, but still you have no taste in hearing Harikatha, sweet pastimes of Krishna, then everything is in vain. If you are chanting 3 lakhs Harinam, you are sannyasi, you are brahmachari, you are vihastha, bhakta, you are following all these things, but no taste in Harikatha, hearing sweet pastimes of Krishna by a bona fide person, oh, like there some are talking themselves, laughing, joking, they have no taste in hearing, then what we can tell them? They have come from so far away to hear Harikatha, or they are laughing, joking there. No taste in hearing. After some time you feel that if he was chanting 3 lakhs name and after some he will give up. Sannyasi will give up sannyas. Brahmachari, his saffron cloth he will give up. I see here also, there are so many weak persons. So unfortunate, bogus. They have no intelligence. They have served so much Guru Vaishnava for long 15 or 16 years or 25 years. And still we, it means they have no taste in hearing katha. So they give up and they married and they did. So I am coming to remind all these things that first we should have sarvanam kirtanam, first sarvanam. We should have taste in hearing sweet pastimes of katha. Prahlad Maharaj and Jamalarjun and others, they have prayed to Krishna, Adav Prabhu, anywhere you can send by my previous karmas, bad or good, even in hell. But please give us association of high Vaishnavas that I can hear Harikatha. This is most important. And that is why it has been told Sadhu Sangha, Sadhu Sangha, Sadhu Sangha, Sadhu Sangha. So, Sadhu Sangha means to hear Harikatha. And then we will be expert. And you will serve Gurudev, then you will be qualified to tell Harikatha yourself. Kirtana. First Savanam, then Kirtana. So, we must have some taste in Harikatha. But if you have no Harikatha taste, then what? Again and again. Have a sleep to beat mind horse, uncontrolled horse, that mind. And, I must go there. If sleeping is coming there, no harm. Take some
chili powder.
Chili dust and give in your eye. But sit there. By this, taste will come. Srila Rupa Goswami has taught in 6th or 7th. Krishnam.
Sat-Krishnam
Kirtadi Sukhtana Rukhraveena Rasana Manasi Niyogya Yada. In Purva. Sat-Krishnam Very, very, very unfortunate. So, this in Harikatha is essential. Dharmasya hi apavardas. Why we are doing religious things? It is not for this, but it is for bhakti. What we are doing? Collecting money. Not for sense gratification, like Punja Parivar of Fiji. Everything in temple making, publishing books and so many things, their wealth is going on in this. So if some wealth is there, use in Krishna Bhakti. So, everything, Vairagya is not Vairagya, if it is not turns into bhakti. So, Vadanti tattva vidas tattam jajjnanam advayam brahmeti paramatmeti. So, those who know tattva, they tell all advayam krishnai tattva. All the incarnations of Krishna like Ram, Nisimha, Kalki, Paman, they are not independent Lord. No. Also, Jivas are coming from them by His Tatastha Shakti. And this world coming from His illusory Maya. So, they have also no separate existence. Only Krishna has separate existence. So Krishna is Advaitya. Brahmagyani from very far away did see same Krishna as a light. This is for only Ansikhi. Only Part of that person, Prabhu. And Paramatma, only sotar and cheat, but ansi, partly. And Swayam Bhagavan is Krishna, his whole, in all respect. So this is the Krishna Supreme Term. Ete chanskala punsa krishnastu bhagavan. So Krishna is Supreme Lord. Tadda sabda dhana munyo jnana vairagya yuktaya pasyant atmani cha atmanam bhaktya sukhirya. First go to Gurudev, qualified Gurudev. He can remove all your doubts because he has some realization. He knows all these shastras. He is perfect in that. And he detached from worldly things. So, go and hear from them. And then, bhakti will come in your heart. And thus, your life will be successful. Śrīmatāṁ svatatha. Now, śrīmatāṁ svatatha.
Om Jnana Tirandasya Jnana Manjana Shalakaya
चक्षुर्मिलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। First of all, I'm offering my Dandi Bhakti Nams to the Lord's feet of my beloved Gurudev, Nityadi Mahaprabhishtha, Om Vishnu Pada Svotara Sattva Shri Srimad, Esi Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj Prabhupada. And secondly, I'm offering my equal Dandi Bhakti Nams and my Shraddha Pushpanjali to the Lord's feet of my beloved Sikhs and Gurus, Nityadi Mahaprabhishtha, Om Vishnu Pada Svotara Sattva Shri Srila Bhakti Rakshak Shri Bhargava Swami Maharaj, and Om Vishnupada Astotara Sattva Shri Srila Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj. And to the lotus feet of all of my Rupanuga Guru Varga, and my pranams to all the Vaishnavas, Vaishnavis, friends and guests in this auspicious assembly to hear Harikatha from the lips of a pure devotee of Krishna.
There was a lady who was singing
the first canto,
very melodious,
of Srimad Bhagavatam, wherein Sri Goswami and the sages of Naivasharanya, they are contemplating how the soul, how the Atma, the eternal soul, can achieve full satisfaction, can become samprasinnati, transcendentally satisfied and happy. And he has introduced us to the preceding verses in which it is clearly defined that bhakti to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Bhagavan Sri Krishna, this is the ultimate dharma, the ultimate duty of the soul, and nothing else will ever satisfy the soul except this. And he has described that without attaining attachment and attraction to hearing the transcendental messages of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, then no matter what we are doing in this world, it is shrava edahi kevalam, simply useless labor, because at the time of death, nothing can be brought with us. So Srimad Bhagavatam herein is describing the transcendental process by which, hearing the transcendental message of Srimad Bhagavatam and the Supreme Lord Sri Krishna, how that transcendental message will enter into our ears and into our hearts, and the process will be performed by the power and the potency of Harikatha to cleanse our hearts and bring us into complete transcendental realization of the Supreme Lord, Tattva Jnana, as Gurudev was describing, all Tattva Jnana being obtained and realizing one's eternal relationship with Krishna and ending this cycle of repeated birth and death. So here, this verse of Srimad Bhagavatam is beginning with the explanation of hearing Krishna Katha. Srimatam Svakata Krishna Punya Shravana Kirtana Vidyantak Stohi Avantrami Vidunoti Suhitsatam. Here it is said that Krishna's own topics about himself are none different than himself. Krishna's name, qualities, form, pastimes, and his Harikatha, they are supremely powerful, just as Krishna himself is. And when one hears these transcendental messages from the lips of the pure, realized Mahabhagavat Vaishnava, then there is a power in that Harikatha, because Krishna himself comes in the form of this Harikatha and enters into one's ears and into one's heart. And then Krishna begins the process of cleansing the heart for the sincere devotee. Srinivatam Svakata Krishna Punya Shravana Kirtana. This process of Shravan Kirtan, hearing and chanting these divine messages, is the topmost activity that can be performed by the human being. And, Vidyantakstohi Avatrami, within our hearts, because we are conditioned souls for millions of lifetimes in this material world, there is so much inauspicious things, like dust on the mirror, dust covering the mirror. You cannot see any image when you look in the mirror. Similarly, our hearts are full of so many inauspicious desires and anarthas, unwanted things. So by the process of hearing Krishna Katha, Then cleansing of the heart, it begins by the power of Krishna Tattva. And then nashta prayeshu abhadreshu nityam bhagavata sevaya bhagavati uttama shloke bhaktir bhavati naishiki. So now, by the process of hearing and the heart becoming cleansed, nashta prayeshu abhadreshu, not fully, but for the most part, now the cleansing process has become effective. And nityam bhagavata sevaya, how is this happening? Because the devotee is engaging regularly, constantly, nityam bhagavata sevaya. He's constantly serving the message of Srimad Bhagavatam by hearing Harikatha, and also the other type of Bhagavat, he is called Bhakta Bhagavat. So he is constantly engaged in serving the divine orders of the spiritual master, of the pure devotee, living his life according to his direction. So by performing this practice, then constantly, Bhagavati uttama shloke bhaktir bhavati naishtiki. Now, pure devotion, pure bhakti yoga, as we heard Shripad Damodar Raj explaining the definition of shuddha bhakti, uttam bhakti, devoid of all other material desires and only fully concentrating 24 hours on Krishna and his happiness. So in this way, bhaktir bhavati naishtiki, it becomes manifested within one's heart in the form of naishtiki bhakti. Naishtiki means unwavering. Always constantly, like a stream of honey that is flowing. So bhakti is going on 24 hours a day with one's mind, body, words, and bhavs, emotions. So then, tada rajastamo bhava kama lobha dayashtaye cheta etar anavidham sitam sattve sasidati. So now, in this material world, there are the impulses which are born of the modes of material nature. These are called triguna. They are called sattva, rajas, and tamas, goodness, passion, and ignorance. And by the force of these three modes of the mayak, the illusory potency of the Supreme Lord, therefore all living entities are impelled to act and to have the lower qualities imbibed within their mind and heart, like lust, anger, envy, illusion, and so forth. So in this way, this kama lobha, lust and anger and greed and so forth, now all these effects, they become completely extinguished. Cheta etayana vitam. Now one's consciousness, the pure consciousness of the soul, no longer becomes touched by these external modes of nature. And sthitam sattve prasidati. Now the devotee becomes situated in sattva, pure goodness, where now he can completely focus and he is not agitated by the external attractions and illusions of this material world. Then, evam prasanna manaso bhagavat bhakti yogataha bhagavat tattva vijnanam mukta sangasya jayate. So now, evam prasanna manaso, now in this condition, when he's doing bhakti to Krishna, he feels great peacefulness and satisfaction within his mind, within his heart. Bhagavat bhakti yogataha and bhagavat tattva vijnanam. He attains, as Srila Gurudev described, pure transcendental tattva jnana. He realizes his own soul. He realizes, I am Atma, I am not this material body. I have nothing to do with this material world and all the so-called possessions of this body in this material world. And he gains knowledge, Bhagavat tattva. True knowledge of the Supreme Personality of Godhead is manifest within his heart. He understands what is the illusory energy of Maya and all these different tattva jnana. He comes to understand clearly and realize. And mukta sangasya jayate. Now he becomes mukta. That means he becomes liberated. He becomes untouched by the effects of all illusion in this world. And he becomes a mukta jeev, liberated soul. And then, pityate, hridaya, grantis, Chityante Sarva Samshaya Shiyante Chatsya Karvani Drishta Evat Manishwari. Now Vidyate, the Vibhaya Granta, the knot that is within our heart binding us to this material world. Now it becomes pierced, that knot becomes loosened. Chityante Sarva Samshaya. Now all doubts, all illusory attractions to this world, they become completely shattered by the power of this divine realization. And Chiyate Chasti Karmani, now all of the constant chain of karma that has bound us in this material world repeatedly, lifetime after lifetime, now it becomes terminated. And Drishta Evatman Ishvare, now the devotee realizes the presence of the Supreme Lord, who is known as Ishvara, the Supreme Controller of all. He is within our hearts, sitting next to our Atma, as Srila Gurudev told us in the beginning of his lecture, that we are the Atma, we are the tiny, infinitesimal, spiritual, eternal particle, and He is the Supreme, unlimited Supreme Lord, and He is accompanying us within our own heart as the Paramatma. So when we understand Krishna Evatmanishvare, that the Supreme Lord Himself is the controller of all, then we fully surrender at His lotus feet and attain our eternal relationship with Him. This is the power of hearing Srimad Bhagavatam and hearing from the lips of a pure realized guru, pure devotee of Krishna. This is the most auspicious activity that we can perform. So if we clearly open our eyes, open our ears, our hearts, and fully accept this divine message as Srila Gurudev is telling us during these few coming days, then the power of this Hare Katha will begin this process, as you just heard, within your own hearts, and we will attain our divine relationship with Krishna.
Hearing all this from Sukha Goswami, Sonat, and 88,000 of Rishi, they can very happy. And they were wondering that, oh, bhakti is so glorious. Please tell us how this bhakti really can come in our heart. Our heart is full of so many unwanted things, unless worldly desires. Please be merciful and tell us. Then he told, without Guru, you cannot have bhakti. Even Krishna cannot give you bhakti. Krishna is Supreme Lord. He can do anything. He is independent. But He cannot give bhakti. Why? Because if He is giving bhakti to one person and not to other, then this blame will come and this partiality is in Krishna. And Mahabharata, like Sukadeva Goswami and others, Narada Goswami, they are Mukta Mahapurush, liberated persons. Oh, they cannot do mercy. By their mercy, bhakti will not come. From where? Madhyam Adhikari Bhakta. Prema Maitri Kripa Peksha Jaha Karoti Se Madhyamaha. Love and affection to Krishna and maitri, three kinds of maitri. Those who are superior Vaishnava, maitri with sattvic. Those who are equal, maitri with maitri. And those who are juniors, maitri with mercy. And those who are innocent, no bhayavar,
or you should do kripa to them.
And those who are against Krishna,
oh, avoid them.
This is the qualification of a Madhyam Adhikari. So these Madhyam Adhikari Vaishnava can really hurt you. Now, in his Mahabhava stage talent, but he will descend in Madhyam Adhikari and then he can be bhakti, otherwise not. So the backbone of bhakti, the source of reservoir of bhakti is Madhyam Adhikari, this Vaishnava Bhakta. So how easily it can be? Then Sukh Goswami began to tell, I will tell you something. How Guru is merciful and how he is qualified. I will tell the story of Narada and Vyasa. Narada divided all the Vedas. Very, very difficult.
Yes.
Very difficult. So he divided in four Vedas. Rigveda, Samaveda, Yajurveda, Atharvaveda. And then he took the essence of all these four Vedas and composed Brahma Sutra about 50 Sutra. Sutra means
condensed form.
Condensed form. But he again thought, these are very, very hard, general people cannot understand. What to do? Then he made
Mahabharata.
Purans. All other Purans. Mukta Puran, Upa Puran, Saka Puran. 36 kinds of Puran. Even he was not satisfied. Then he made Pancham Ved,
Mahabharata.
For Sutra. For Brahmins, for rishis, going from all, for all. But he was not satisfied. Even Brahma received Chatushloki Bhagavat. And he told to Narada. And mercifully Narada told to Vyasa. But even he was not satisfied by that. So one day he was thinking, I have done so many things. A common person cannot do like this. But where is my mistake? I cannot do. My soul is not held. I am not held. What is the reason behind? And in the same time, Devasi Lord came with his Veena. Then, that day, washed his feet and gave passion to him, gave water to drink. And when he was satisfied and sat easily, then Narada-rishi told, oh Prabhu, you are not a common person. You are Saptavesh avatar of Narayan. But I see that you are not happy. Why you are not happy? Then Vyasa told, oh Gurudev, I have done all these things as you are telling. But I don't know why I am
unhappy.
You are doctor and scientist. You can so many.
Kill the pulse.
And you can decide. So a disciple cannot know fight is unhappy, but Guru knows. No need of
feeling the pulse.
Looking pulses, or he will see your face and tell everything. Why you ask? You know, don't know what he knows. By one clarity, then Lord told Prabhu, who had done so many things, but as you have discussed all these things, dharma, varnasam dharma, varnasam dharma, the dharma of Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Sudra, Sannyasi, Brahmachari,
Vanprastha
and
Grihastha.
You have done all these things. But when bullies are dead, you have not told them there the glories of Krishna. No sweet Haritatha of Krishna. That is why your mind is disturbed and you are not happy. Shagani Sum, tell him, wait. You are patiently, with care, to follow Bhakti. Guru Bhakti is born of Bhakti. Guru Nishtha is
I offer up my humiliated obeisances in the dust of the lotus feet, and my most worshipable Vishnu Gurudev, Nityananda Pravishna, Om Vishnu Pai, bestowed this at the Sri Srimad Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. And the same unlimited obeisances in the dust of the lotus feet of my most worshipful Shiksha Gurudev, Om Vishnu Pai, bestowed to this at the Sri Srimad Shri Bhaktivedanta Narayana Goswami Maharaj, for all of us, Sister of Succession, and all the assembled devotees. Shri Gurudev has ordered me to discuss the teachings of Sri Narada Muni to Shri Vyasadeva. As Shri Gurudev mentioned, Narada Muni is a Mahabhagavat, a resident also of the spiritual world. But in order to show mercy to those in this material world, he took the role of a Madhyama Adhikari who makes four distinctions. So to his disciple, Vyasadeva, he is giving now instructions. He asked Vyasadeva that you've discussed and described the glories of Varnashram. You discussed all the heavenly planets and how to get there. You divided all the Vedas, you wrote the Puranas and the Mahabharata for the less intelligent. So, still you're unhappy? Why is that? Because you've neglected to glorify the personality of Godhead. Any words that do not describe the glories of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is the only sanctifying deity in the material world, whose service alone can sanctify all the three worlds. Such words are known by saintly persons to be a pilgrimage of the crows. On the other hand, that transcendental literature, which glorifies the name, fame, form, personality of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, is another type of creation, which acts as a revolution in the impious lives and the dust-worn hearts of civilization. So he's trying to encourage Srila Vyasadeva. He says that people generally want to enjoy, so they will misunderstand what you're trying to do in the Vedas and use whatever Vedic literatures you've written as an excuse to enjoy within my Varnashram life, or an excuse to go to the heavenly planets. Or when that all fails, then I'll merge and become one with the impersonal God. So he's encouraging him. I'll tell you how I, myself, became a pure devotee. And by this you can understand how by surrender to Guru, how by hearing and glorifying the Lord, you reach all perfection. And then I want you to enter into trance, because you're so qualified that you can enter into trance and sing within your heart all the pastimes of the Lord from beginning to end. And then I want you to describe His glory. So Narada told about his own life. Many times, spiritual masters will explain how they developed their eternally liberated souls, but they explain to increase the faith of the disciple how they became pure devotees. So Narada said that in my previous life, I was the son of a maidservant, a very poor maidservant. And during the rainy season and autumn season, the great sages who generally travel around all over without staying in one place very long, they stay for several months in one place to enlighten the people there. So I was engaged in the service of the Bhaktivedantas, of the great sages. One time, I tasted the remnants of their footsteps. And just by doing that, I became free from all sins. Then, engaging more in their service, I developed an intense attraction for hearing their messages, and I lost all my taste for anything else. I was very well behaved, quiet, and gentle, and I wasn't interested in frivolous sports. So hearing and hearing from them about the glories of the Lord, I got a great greed to serve the Lord. Then, though, the time passed and the great sages left. But just before they left, they instructed me on the confidential message of the Lord, and I desired to be with them and leave my family connection. Family connection means my mother. But my mother had only me, so she lavished me with all of her affection. But because I had a great desire to serve these Bhaktivedantas and become a pure devotee and glorify the Lord, Krishna made the arrangement that one night, my mother, as she was going out for milking the cows, she was bit on the leg by a serpent, and she immediately died. I did not lament over this. I took this as the mercy of the Lord. And I, without even looking back, I left and went to search out the Lord in the forest. Vyasadeva asked Narada, "After initiation, please tell me what you did." And Narada explained that I went to all the towns and villages and woodlands, and whenever I was tired, I just went to the rivers and drank water. I became so detached. Then I went to a very sacred, holy place by the river. And Narada is explaining that in this first stage, this is his first career, he had some slight little desire. And what was that? Not like us, who are so filled with desires. I want to eat the nicest foods, I want to see the nicest thing on TV, I want all the praise, I want all the respect, I want the nicest amount of money and comforts, as Gurudev was explaining. But Narada just had one slight little material desire, and that was in the mode of goodness. He wanted to worship the Lord in a very sanctified, sacred place. So he meditated, controlling his senses and his mind. And after many, many years of austerities and meditation, the Lord appeared to him just for one moment and then disappeared. And then the Lord told him that I will not appear to you again in this life because you have a slight desire. So in order to purify yourself, the Lord said in an aerial voice, not again showing his form, in order to purify yourself, you should engage wholeheartedly and traveling all over the world and glorifying me, singing my glories with a very humble heart and free from all envy. So Narada told Vyasadeva that I did that, and thus I became very, very advanced. So advanced that as a product of my devotional service, as a very, very insignificant byproduct, all mystic powers came in my heart. All transcendental knowledge came to me, spiritual TV in the heart to see everything, spiritual and material, and all the animistic powers, like one can reach out to another planet, just like that, and get it through. One can become heavier than a universe, it can become lighter than the atom, you can bring anyone under his control. So I got that just as an insignificant byproduct of devotional service. And then, as I gradually approached the time of leaving my body, simultaneously, just as lightning and thunder happened simultaneously, so I left my body and I get my transcendental body, which is free from the influence of the modes of nature. And now I can travel everywhere, all throughout the spiritual world, throughout the material world, to Ayodhya, to Vaikuntha, to Brahmaloka, even Narada Muni goes to Goloka Vrindavan and associates with the devotees there. Then he ordered Sri Vyasadeva that you haven't described the glories of the Lord. You've told so many other things, but have you explained how Mother Yasoda would twist Krishna's ear and chastise him and make Krishna weep and make him surrender to her? Oh no, Gurudev, I haven't done that. Then what have you written? Have you written how Krishna would play challenging games with his coward boyfriends and he would defeat them or they would defeat him? In fact, he took more pleasure when they defeated him. And Krishna would say, oh, I defeated you because you're sitting on me and your nose was looking down and my nose is looking up, so I defeated you. Have you written about any of this? Vyasadeva said, no, I didn't know about it. How could I write? So what have you written? Nothing. And have you written how Krishna surrendered his peacock feather and his flute at the lotus feet of Srimati Radhika and begged her, please forgive me, I'll never offend you again? And he fully surrendered at her lotus feet? No, Gurudev, I haven't. Then you haven't given anything for the real welfare of society. Therefore, you should now go into trance. And yes, they had full faith in Narada. When Narada first arrived, as Srila Gurudev explained, he worshipped him and gave him a worshipable seat, washed his feet. And he told him, oh Lord, you are just like the sun who can travel everywhere over the three worlds. And you are just like the air which penetrates the inner regions of everything and the hearts of all living entities. This is the qualification of a bona fide guru. So Vyasadeva, showing us that even Vyasadeva was the incarnation of the Lord, he surrendered to Guru. He couldn't be successful without Guru, surrendering to Guru, so what to speak of us? So Narada instructed him to go in trance. So Vyasadeva, after Narada left, went into the trance of mystic yoga. And he saw from beginning to end Krishna's birth, Krishna's killing Putana, all the other demons, Krishna is dancing in Rasalila with the gopis, is going to Mathura, is going to Dwarka, is sending Uddhav hearing Brahma Geet by Srimati Radhika, all the pastimes from beginning to end. And then, Anarthamupasamam Shakshat, Bhakti Yoga Manoksaje, Lokasya Janata Vivvamskakrishat Puttasamvita. He saw everything in his trance of Bhakti Yoga. And then knowing that Anartam Upasamam Shakshat, all Anartas, 16 kinds of Anartas, offenses, not understanding the goal, not understanding the process, desiring heavenly planets, merging, material enjoyment, all the Anartas are at once mitigated by the process of devotional service. But the whole world does not know this. And therefore, the great sage Vyasadeva compiled that Samhita and the mode of goodness, the Srimad Bhagavatam. Vedyam Vastavamacha Vastu Shivadam Tapachayam Muvanam. The Srimad Bhagavatam is the highest truth, and that truth uproots all the threefold miseries of all living entities. So by the mercy of Sri Narada, Vyasadeva attained perfection, and perfection in his writing, and now we have the beautiful Srimad Bhagavatam, which the manifestation of Sri Vyasadeva, that is Srila Gurudev, the manifestation of Vyasadeva, the manifestation of Narada, the manifestation of Nityananda, the manifestation of Srimati Radhika, the manifestation of Sri Rupa Goswami and Rupa Manjari, Srila Gurudev will teach us that Srimad Bhagavatam and try to put that in our hearts so that we can be happy.
Gurudev can ask one question. Is Narada
traveling?
Is Narada traveling alone?
Narada. He's traveling by himself? Narada. Alone.
Come on. I'm not here.
বলছে নারদ সে একাই ভ্রমণ করার সঙ্গে কাকে নিয়ে ভ্রমণ করে আমাদের প্রচার হয় যেমন সঙ্গে সঙ্গে কাউকে নিয়ে যায় সে নারদ সে কাউকে সঙ্গে নিয়ে ঘুরে কি একাই ঘুরেন
শব্দ ব্রহ্ম বীণা হি টেক্স এন্ড অ্যাপ্রিল হেয়ার ইট ইজ নো নিড অফ ডিসাইপল নো নিড অফ এনিওয়ান সম বাট হোয়ার হি গোস দি মেটস ডিসাইপলস লাইক
প্রহ্লাদ মহারাজ ধ্রুব মহারাজ
বাল্মীকি Prahlad,
Vyasdev,
Valmiki, and so many, one top to bottom.
Sometimes he travels with Angira Rishi.
But
sometimes Narad Muni travels also with other rishis.
So sometimes, if needed, he takes Angira Rishi or other Rishi also, like him, those who are his friends, as needs. So, you should know what Narad told, how easily bhakti comes. She told, but you could not get attention. Narkor, when I was 5 years boy, some rishis came. That rishis were Sanat Sanandar, Sanatan, Sanat Kumar and others. And for 4 months of rainy season, they were there. They made hot and there they used to tell Hari Katha. So, Narad mother, Narad Rishi's mother was cleaning their pots and everything, clearing places and everything. So, Narad, only 5 years old, used to go with her mother, his mother. And one day, he asked them, oh, may I you please give your remnant one day call, only one day. And they saw that this boy is very, very sincere. She may have the bhakti easily. So kindly they gave their remnant to him. And by taking one time event, partaken, ruchi prajayate, in Harikatha, oh, this came. And then I began to hear all these things, what they discussed in 4 months. Everything I knew by then. So, Bhakti Pada Jal, Bhakta Pada Jal are Bhakta
Pada Bhuli. Bhakta Pada Jal, Bhakta Bhukta Sestin
Sadhana. 18 Sadhana Erbal.
18 Seva Haite, Krishna Prema Hai, Puna Puna Sarva Sastri, Tukari Akar.
If any high class of Vaishnava, two kinds of remnants. What they take prasadam? Or oh, that prasadam may I take? Not like, oh Prabhu, give me. And personally taking their remnant. Not that. Bhakta Bhakti Bhuli. Oh, possibly taking, making it down and taking her finger. When they are walking and they will go, oh, they should not see and take. Revenant, please, may I take some? Or feed dust and also water.
Feed by the water.
No, please wash water.
They are very, very powerful. By this, bhakti is given. And that is why Narada told, by these ways, I am tasting, hearing Harikatha. And by hearing Katha, all things came. They did my mantra, and by the power of mantra, I saw Krishna in a glance. And after that, when death came, I put my feet on the
head of death.
And that body went on and go
finished.
And then transcendental form. In transcendental form, so beautiful. He began to travel the whole world in Vrindavan, in Narayan Lok,
Navadvip,
in
Ajodhya,
Mahaprabhu Dham, Ajodhya Dham, in heaven, even in Vrindavan, even in Dwarka, everywhere, like Krishna. So, sadhu-sangha, sadhu-sangha, sarva-sarva-sarva. That day, for ignorant persons, what he saw in his meditation of thorns, he wrote in the form of a book. And he saw that in this world only one his son, Sukadev, detached from birth, when his birth, he came out of his mother's womb, he had once fled away from there, and he went to forest, and that day was calling, Putra, 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 and what voice coming? Echo came from trees. Oh, who is son? Who is father? Who is mother?
Moha eva hi karanam.
And how he was detached from world? That when he was going, oh, his father also following him. And he saw his father, that there were so many aspirant girls that were taking bath naked. And when they saw Sukadeva Swami, as a 16 years old, quite naked, they had no shame at all. But when they saw this old person, all white, when that they went there, they took all their clothes and came and did pranam. When that they asked, my son, as a 16 years old, very beautiful, naked, but you have no shame at all, and from me, why you are a son? Then he told, in his
vision,
all are like tree, like stones. He sees what? Only Krishna and what?
Atma.
He Krishna always, nothing else. He not saying that he is lady or he is male or he is what, he is tiger or what. His only vision is that, in all hearts, Supreme Lord is there. So he seen there. So for him, no sin. But if you are asking that we are lady and you are male, you are thinking. That is why we have so. So from but he was detached from whole world. And he had Brahma, he was Brahmaniya. Means
absorbed in Brahma.
Always Brahma. What Brahma?
creator of this Brahm world. No form, nothing. But I think so many things. But when he heard Hari Katha, the glories of Krishna, the qualities of Krishna, the beauty of Krishna, Bhagavadam, Natavarabhu, Karnayo, Karnikar, Bhikkhadvasa, Kalakkapisam, Vairajayanti, Chamalam, Nandhana Deyu, Rakasudhaya, Pure and Gok Vindai, Vindarandam, Savadarvanam, Prabhu. Best beauty of Krishna. Gopis are telling like this. And for quality, Aho Bhakti Yam Spankalu Kutam. Oh, how he is merciful. A demon like Putana, taking the blood and flesh of a boys, he went to kill Krishna and to give poison. And Krishna, with poison, he sold his tooth and purified. And she achieved the Dhatri Uchit Gati. How he is so merciful, we must serve them. That Krishna. Why we should serve all very gods, those are anyone. Go Priman.
Them, sir. Hey, the them, sir.
Oh. They should send many.
Them, sir, them, sir, Sena.
So they should come. Why not come?
Where is them, sir?
Where is my
guest? He has begun to do it. He has taken off.
Can I ask a question?
Question.
Gurudev, you said that these substances are very powerful. The water that washed the feet of the pure devotee and the remnants of his foodstuffs.
And also Hari Katha.
And the Hari Katha. So Hari Katha the devotees can hear all the time by reading books or hearing your tapes or watching on Pure Bhakti TV. But it seems like they can only get your food remnants or the water that washed your lotus feet once or twice a year. So how can they get it more often?
Is there another way? First Nara, like Shankar, when he takes a remnant and he becomes to dogs, and Parvati also becomes to dogs.
Now, Bolshe,
I have to say that. They should come, otherwise I will go.
Tonight, some of our young girls performed a small Indian dance to welcome everyone. Gopali Devi has been teaching these young girls for the past year or so. We hope to enjoy their little welcome dance.
Krishna.
Hare Krishna, everybody. I'd just like to welcome you all for coming to this Hare Guru Vaishnava festival. We have over 400 devotees here tonight. This is the biggest turnout we've ever had in the history of our festivals here. So thank you all. Thank you all. Feeling good that you're just making your way here. So we feel very encouraged.